Grow My Cleaning Company teaches owners of cleaning companies just like you how to grow your company, make more money, and finally take charge of your financial future and your life. This podcast is about automating and creating systems that give you time and money freedom so you can grow like crazy without losing control. Since this is totally free, if you're getting tons of value, want to support us and make sure that you get more of the good stuff, subscribe, rate, and review to this podcast today. Now, on to the show. Hey, Clean Nation, Mike Campion here with the semi-good-looking, very intelligent, depending on the day, Jackson Pinky Pinkowski, our paid traffic rock star. And we have him on today because, frankly, he has been kicking butt and taking names with our Next Level members. And I think he just wanted to come on to brag. Am I correct? Or have I completely missed why you're here?
Yeah, basically brag. I mean, I had someone do the math the other day and tell me that I'm 67% better than the Google representative that they saw. So I don't know how they calculated it, but I'll take it.
If you came with 67% better than Jared, now that I'd be happy with. He kind of helps the elite and does our ads. And as is their custom, Jackson and Jared bust chops. But frankly, no offense to our friends at Google, I would imagine you got to be like 4,000% better than the Google reps. Those guys are, I don't say terrible, but would not great be fair? Or am I completely missing it?
They've got a job to do, and I get it. And they work for a company, and they give the best practices based off of what's going to be good for that company, right? And that's fair. I understand it. But they don't take that individualized approach. And basically, you know, to surmise what happened is I was working with someone on Google Ads for probably the past 3-4 months, and they were doing extremely well, had great return, was getting great traffic, was getting on average like 5-6 calls a week just for potential cleaning contracts.
Is this commercial or residential?
On the commercial side. This is commercial. And of course, this caught the attention of Google, because now you're spending more money in the platform, you're getting traction, and Google notices that and says, hey, well, maybe we want to extend a helping hand. And they did that. And this person took them up on that helping hand, and it ended up just tanking everything that we ended up putting together. And I was surprised, because usually that doesn't happen. But he did the math, and he said, yeah, what we were doing is you know, 67% better than what Google's doing. So we had to reverse.
I'm just glad he's doing math, as opposed to going, I liked what you did and I didn't like what Google. I like there's a definitive mathematical answer. All right. So let's start kind of at the beginning. So we talk a lot about, I think the reason that people are on this particular podcast are like, hey man, I want to get more leads that turn into customers. So we talk a lot about Facebook, and internally we agree on my cleaning company to get clients to use a lot of Facebook, and we coach our clients to use that. Let's just spend like 3 minutes there, and then we'll kind of talk about Google, because we haven't talked about that a lot. So what circumstances, we're recording this kind of early first quarter 2021, what circumstances at this point would you, because you know, the stuff changes, kind of the nuance and things, but what circumstance would you recommend Facebook versus Google and vice versa?
Yeah. So,
well, actually, before we even do that, let's go paid. And there's such a big universe, right? So both Google and pay and Facebook have paid and organic opportunities. Maybe we'll have you on next for the organic, right? Because a lot of people want free, and it's tough because free is great because it's free, but it takes a lot of, it's not free. It costs time, right? If you're not going to spend money, you're going to spend time, and it's not as scalable, right? You can't double it tomorrow. So we'll see. If you guys want to hear Jackson come back and talk free traffic, organic traffic, let me know. We'll do that. But today, let's just restrict it to paid because there's too much. So for both Google, obviously you can do SEO, search engine optimization, or you can pay them. For Facebook, it's a social platform, so you can just kind of go in and do what you can, or you can pay them. So let's stick with paid. Why would you recommend, and what circumstances would you recommend Google versus Facebook and vice versa for paid traffic for both residential and commercial?
Yeah. So I guess probably like the biggest difference between the two platforms is mindset of the customer on the other end. So starting with Facebook, you're getting people who are scrolling through the feed, procrastinating. They're not actively searching for your offering, your service, whether it be residential or commercial cleaning. They might be on other platforms, but your main goal with Facebook is to hit people in your target area. that may be in a certain income bracket or have certain types of interests or be a certain gender. And then you can, you're utilizing what you know your customers' pain points are to kind of highlight why they would want to go with a potential cleaning service, whether it be residential or commercial. At that point, the messaging is really what's different, because residential, you're selling somebody that owns a home, and commercial, a lot of times people see it as, oh, I'm selling to a business. Well, no, there's still a decision maker on that other end that you have to, that you're selling on, right? It is B2B, but still sort of B2C in a way, because somebody's swiping the credit card, somebody's making the decision to go with you. And that's based off of their pain points that they're experiencing, whether it's, you know, loss of time at the work, wearing too many hats, all this different stuff. But Facebook is like making sure that your company, your brand, your messaging, what your value add to them is in front of their face, based off of what they're looking for on their daily social media feed, really.
And that's a good point. I don't want you guys to miss that. We think there's B2B and B2C, and Jack said it perfect. There is no such thing as B2B. Any B you can think of, Disney, think of the biggest business you can think of. Disney has never purchased one thing. Susie in accounting, or Jackson in accounting, that dude, that lady, she has a credit card. She has a purchase power. She has the power of the pen. She or he purchases things. And just like Jackson said, you know, Google to a degree wants to help their clients, but first and foremost, they want to help them. And quite frankly, whoever that guy or gal on the other end of the phone really want to help him personally. And he did that through doing his job so he could get paid and blah, 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 on down the road. So I think one of the biggest mistakes commercial B2B cleaners make is they try to sell the companies or they try to sell the facility managers. But there's Jackson, you know, for us does a lot of stuff, but say his title is traffic guru. When he goes and introduces himself to people, he's like, I'm Jackson. I'm a dad. Well, he's not a dad. I'm a husband or husband to be. I'm a Midwesterner. He's got lots of things that he would identify, but like his title ain't it, right? So if you try to reach out to him on Facebook as paid traffic manager, he might respond, but Hick, who likes to wear a cowboy hat now and again and go to Bucks games, he's all in. He's like, that, holy crap, that's me, right? So if you're going to get into his wallet, whether it would be Grow My Cleaning Company's wallet, him spending money for us, or his personal wallet, you'd be a lot better with Hick, who wears a cowboy hat and looks great in it periodically, than, you know, paid traffic manager. So just want to be super clear, guys, gals, do that. All right. So Facebook, my short thing, and Jackson, say tell me if there's anything else and we'll move on to Google, because you've been kicking butt with that, is the traffic's going to be a little cooler, right? They're not looking for this thing. They're just wandering the earth trying to find pictures of their grandkids or whatever they're doing. And you kind of have to direct their attention and get it. So the messaging has to be a little more powerful. And it might be a little longer of a process, but there's a lot more of them, right? On the Google side, if I'm typing in best, you know, residential cleaning company in Phoenix, there's a good chance I'm looking for a residential cleaning company in Phoenix. But there's only so many people that are going to be typing that in, right? And especially on the commercial side, how many people are typing one of the dozens of search terms you can have? So is that fair that Facebook's a little less scalable, or a little more scalable, but a little less direct? And it's typically cheaper, right? Because there is no intent. It's just like some human being, a click might cost a buck or two, whereas on Google, it might cost four or five. Google might be a little more targeted people, but they're also going to pull up seven of your ads, right? You can't pay like Google $3 for a click or $20 for them only to see your ad. They can only see your ad with everyone else trying to compete for that. Is that a good overview, or do we miss any big chunks?
No, that's essentially it. It's like if you're baking a cake, Facebook is putting all the ingredients into the pot, and then Google is when you put the cake in the oven. Because you know it's gonna come out. Because Google is the main primary goal with Google is when you know somebody's searching for commercial cleaning in Milwaukee, right? You want to be number one on that list when it pops up for them, because they've already made the decision in their head. I want to find this. I need to find this. And I see this, and it attracts me. It's got the pain points I'm going through. It's got a valuable offer here. I'm gonna click, give them a call. I'm gonna go to their address or email them, whatever that may be. But on the Google side, yeah, you want to be right up there, ready to go when people come calling.
And obviously Jackson's going to be a little biased because he's specialized in paid traffic, not organic, but let's talk just about that difference for a second. Then we'll talk specifically what you're doing in Google. It's working for our people right now. But when I was kind of younger in business, I wanted the SEO stuff. I wanted to be on the top of the search for Google. As I kind of get older and have a little more experience, I'm like, I think I'd rather just buy it, because The top with Google, first of all, there's no such thing as ranked number one in Google. There's ranked number one in Google for a specific search term first. And there might be 50 search terms that you think that you want, and you might only want 20 of those. And there might be, you know, we can get into negative words and all that sort of stuff, like someone that's searching for a thing that's similar to yours, but not yours. So there's no such thing as being top of Google, right? People are like, oh, I'm number one in the Google search. Like, what? There's an infinite amount of, you got to be more specific. Two, no SEO people are top. Paid is always top, right? So if you want to be number one, the only option is paid, right? I think you can be number one in organic, which is right below the paid. Let's be clear about that. Second, I can be top on Google tomorrow, number one, actual number one at the top of the page. It can take months and months, even with the best of the best SEO guy, magic, whatever. It's still often going to take months and months and months to get that. And Google can change their algorithms, and that's at the end of that, right? Their paid model is never going, I mean, it might change in terms of how we do the bidding or how much it costs, you know, aspects of it may change, but being able to give American dollars to Google to be actually number one, that concept ain't probably going to go away for a long time. Is that fair?
Yeah, 100%, because you could be top of page and organic. Like if we Google Grow My Cleaning Company, technically Grow My Cleaning Company is top of page underneath probably five or six different ads that you have to scroll past to see the actual Grow My Cleaning Company. So the ads are always going to be in the top. And that is the goal. You put money behind it, you get to the true kind of top of page rate, as they say.
And I think the big mistake, and again, we're kind of getting around to it. I promise we're going to talk about what specific things you're doing that are working well. But the big mistake we make, and then we'll go into it, is people do exactly that. They'll be like, well, if, you know, growing cleaning company, if they're going to search that, I don't want that. I'll pay. And they pay, which is great. And then they go to your website, but your website's not a converting website. It doesn't really have any clear talk about their pain or an offer. It's just like, hey, we're Grow My Cleaning or we're Mike's Cleaning Company and we clean good. And we're a member of the BB, you know, what is it called? The Better Business Bureau. And, you know, click here to join our, you know, newsletter, click here to follow us on Facebook, you know, or call now for a free estimate, but we've given no value. And they're like, I tried Google and it didn't work. It's like, okay. Kind of, I guess you could say that. Yeah, I guess the big thing is we forget when it comes to traffic sources, how important it is where you're sending that traffic has everything to do with it. And so many people send it to a crap website that's not going to convert. And then they blame the source of traffic on the lack of conversion, not the crap website and lack of conversion.
Yeah, essentially. Cool thing about Google too, especially, maybe more so on the commercial side than I will say residential, but the ability to put your phone number in there and, you know, just bypass lazy people in general, because you know some people just want to call and get this set up and get it going. They're right at the cusp. That's like the best you can get in. And Google gives you the ability to, you know, send them right to your phone number, so they can give you a call. You can get get their information, get something on the schedule. You can change up the way your domain looks. So if you're forwarding them even to a funnel, you can make it look like specific tailored experiences for each type of individual, because not every person Googles commercial cleaning that they need. Right. You know, sometimes it's janitorial services. We were talking about someone got a hit on day porter, and I've never heard of the term day porter before, or porter, something like that. And it's like, if you know that that's what people are looking for in your area, you tailor the experiences to them. So, you know, people searching for janitorial services are going to see a landing page tailor-made for them, an ad tailor-made for them, without, you know, having to branch out and do a ton of different things all at one time.
So let's talk about exactly what, because I was literally just on the phone with some of our Next Level people, and one residential said she had five appointments today.
Yeah,
you know who we're talking about. And then we had another commercial one that, and I wanted to hit one of each, that literally this month I think it spent $450 on Google and got a $90,000 contract. So walk us through what you're doing that's working for Facebook or Google, whatever you're doing for those guys, that would kind of help our listeners.
Yeah. So on the Facebook side, it's really setting up the ad. So it's less so of like a typical advertisement you see on Facebook. And I'm sure a bunch of people listening right now have seen ads on Facebook, have probably clicked on them and know what a typical ad looks like. But these ones, kind of establish more of a connection with the business and usually the person on the other side. So it promotes to send a message and to get information. So the business comes away with the customer information and a connection, but then the person feels it's like a more intimate relationship, right? Because you're messaging, you're actually talking with a human being on the other side, learning, not even making an offer, scheduling up a clean. It's just giving more value of learning, you know, what to look for or what kind of services they offer or what kind of stuff there. So that's kind of the action we've taken on Facebook, and it's done extremely well.
So give me just what does that cost per interaction typically? And obviously it could be higher and lower. And what's a good example of an interaction? If we're not going, and again, that's a big mistake somebody of us made is like, hey, I just met you, come, you know, call now for a free clean. And then no one does it. And they're like, oh, this doesn't work. So what's average cost to get one of those interactions? And what would you consider a successful interaction, or how can people set up an interaction that's going to do well for their company?
Yeah. So it typically costs like anywhere from a buck to $2 for an interaction there. That's a good cost. Even a little higher would be okay.
Which if you think about it, you could have 100 interactions for a couple $100. That's a month. That's pretty exciting. And yeah, what would that interaction look like? What would be, you know, something other than call now for a free clean and they ignore it and that costs $2.
Yeah. So it's really like it gives all the power almost to the customer, right? Because they're starting that interaction. So you kind of already have baseline of knowing what they're looking for. Because most of the time they ask for like, what services do you provide? And then you're that interaction back, you're able to outline the services.
And is this by chat or email, or how's this physically happening?
All through chat, all through social media chat, whether it be Facebook or Instagram, one of the two platforms.
And you can run one ad on Facebook and it runs on both Facebook.
Yeah, it will run on both. So they can come through either. And that interaction, yeah, they ask for services and then you provide some value back. And obviously you want to tell them what your services are, or you, and then you provide, you know, there's one, and I'm blanking on, because I was just talking about it today. It was something, it was specifically tailored towards high income homes and looking at like how your cleaner should be treating these, you know, huge homes with expensive countertops, all this kind of stuff. And that was the value add back to the customer. And that usually triggers another interaction back, a follow-up down the line of, hey, did you have any more questions? That kind of stuff. And it always keeps the person on the radar because it is that professional yet closer than just like a form fell out or just a typical mass email that gets sent out.
Well, and let me make a switch to, not a switch, but a clarification on something, or expand on something Jackson said. You know, like it's almost putting all the power into the customer. And if you're an owner like me, that can feel a little scary, right? Like we're used to selling or come on or something where we feel like we can influence the outcome, and to feel like all the power is in the customer's hand can be a little uncomfortable. But let me encourage you, as a business owner, to me, the ultimate power is being able to turn on a spigot of leads and have as many as I want. So I would rather have the ability to go, I'll give you $500 and I want to have 500 or 1,000. Well, no, two or three or 400 of these interactions, 10 a day, where the power is all in their hand. I'm totally okay if the power is all in their hand. I create power in being able to control my own destiny and hit my own goals for my business when I can turn, dial up and down that lead flow. So guys, gals, I would much rather you have a scalable way to attract leads, even if you feel like the leads aren't as hot or as warm or exactly what you want, than a real finite amount of leads that you feel are better. Am I communicating that well, Jackson, or does that come off crazy?
No, it does 100%. And I probably could have clarified that a little bit better, because I realized once I heard you say giving the power to the customer, that even frightens me as a marketer when you hear something like that. But it's less so of, I don't want to even say like the illusion of power to them, but like if you can get a customer to come initiate contact with you, and because people love to talk and they want to tell you, you know, they want to ask a question, and they want to tell you what's going on and why they're reaching out to you in the first place. That gives you insight before you even had to, you know, give value back or start a sales pitch or try and get a bid in or anything like that. So that's kind of the benefit that I see there.
And by the way, I think they have the power anyway, right? Certainly on Facebook, we're trying to talk to them, which is fine, right? Because we have the ability, again, once you get this, I really feel like you're magic. Once you can generate more than enough leads than you want to get more than enough people that want your service and you can even handle, the game's over. That's it. So, all right. What I hear you saying, is this working for residential and commercial, or just residential on this kind of like $1 or $2 reach out where you kind of initiate some sort of a messenger chat with them?
definitely better for residential. I'm not currently doing it with any commercial, not to say it couldn't work or wouldn't work. It's just not something I'm currently doing.
All right. So we are right now in Grow My Cleaning Company getting results for folks with residential or with folks with residential by dollar to institute a chat that turns into an appointment that obviously turns in. Okay. So what is the time commitment? Like, are they spending, cause I'd be like, oh my gosh, who's doing all these chats? And is this like now a part-time job? How's that feel?
It's very minimal. I mean, probably time commitment, maybe like an hour a day. Maybe like an hour and a half. If you put a half hour in the morning, a half hour at lunch, and a half hour in the evening, because Facebook is awesome and you can set up automated responses for, if you see a lot of people ask them right off the bat, what are your services? You can tell it to automatically respond with a response that fits. And if it's something, and then you can take over if they ask a wild question, or, you know, if they do, there are ways to optimize your time really. And it's just, you have to check it a couple times a day to make sure that yes, people are getting responses, or you're having a good response time too. Cause Facebook does report on that. When it sees, when somebody initiates contact with you as a page, it'll say typically replies within the hour if you actually do. And that makes a big difference, because if you don't reply for like 2 days, it will say doesn't reply for 48 hours, which
you can certainly pay someone part-time as a subcontractor to kind of manage this for us. We could certainly hire somebody, have it be one of the jobs of someone on our team. So, you know, if it takes half hour a day, this doesn't have to be a half hour, an hour of your time, but it might be a half hour of someone's time. And then what kind of many bids are you find people are getting if they spend, you know, they're like, I don't have that much money. I can only spend $200 or $300 a month. You know, how many, that might be a couple hundred conversations. How many bids might that generate?
I
think not for the best guy, that's a rock star, not for the worst guy, just a, you know, an average guy.
Yeah. Put it into perspective. I believe, when I was talking with somebody had spent about $234, I want to say, in this past month, and, got a $1,000 recurring bid just off of one. And he had probably had like three or four other bids that actually went through, probably a total of like 10, maybe 12 bids.
For a couple $100. That's insane to me. Insane. Any, by the way, residential folk, commercial, anytime you can get a bid for $100 or two or less is just like, that seems like if you do the math, it's dozens of dollars. Like it's just virtually nothing. All right, let's hit commercial world real quick. What's working on the commercial side with AdWords? What's working, what's not? What can Cleaning Nation do to get that party started?
So what's working? I want to preface all this, what I'm about to say, and just say it takes time. Google is not it's not a fast spigot. It's a slow drip, but it works, but it just takes time.
And by the way, I want to make sure people aren't hearing Facebook fast, Google slow. If you can get it right perfectly in Facebook, it can happen pretty quick, but you probably won't. So I would say if you think you're going to put up an ad today and within a week have lots of leads, certainly possible, but that wouldn't be my plan. Certainly wouldn't be anything I bet on. So when you say slow, we're talking a couple of days, a couple of weeks, a couple of months, where are we at?
About a month.
Okay.
30 to 45 days.
To be fair, Jared or Jackson, sorry, we got Jackson and Jared. They're both our traffic guy. And yeah, every time. My sons are Christian and Caleb. One's 5, one's 21. I call them each other's names. So I have no chance with you guys who are similar in age. So Jackson works with our Next Level members and does calls with them Monday through Friday daily. So obviously you can pay someone to do this, and those can be anywhere from $500 a month to thousands of dollars a month, which again is tough and probably not recommended if you're, you know, only spending $200 or $300 or $400 a month. It's hard to pay a guy $1,000 a month to manage the account. So if you've got, if you're really good at it, like Jackson is, or if you've got someone that can help you, these results are for that. So I don't want you to get disappointed if you don't have anyone help and you're kind of new and it takes you a little longer. Don't feel like, oh, I suck or this doesn't work, or you know what I'm saying? I just want to be fair pool. Like I don't want Jackson saying, oh, they're just out on their own doing this and giving these results. They are getting help from some of those that they're talking about. So in that case, a month, walk us through that.
Yeah. So it really right off the bat, you want to start with a sort of broad net in terms of what you're trying to capture for people. So that means you're spending no more than like $7 to $11 a day on a wide range of general keywords in your area. So keywords like people searching for commercial cleanings, people searching for janitorial services, anything
that facilities management, day porter, all the stuff you're talking about.
All the stuff, yeah. And so you have that going for about a week and a half, and you're spending very minimal bucks, and you know Google might not spend all that money. So you'll learn a lot in a week and a half to 2 weeks just based off of that small spend and that traffic. You'll understand what people are searching for. Because you'll have more impressions. Is your wording, is your landing page experience good for those types of people?
So for the first couple $100, maybe you get some leads, maybe you don't, but if you do it right and you know what you're doing, you'll definitely get data. Is that fair? Or am I?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, absolutely. Because people who have a commercial cleaning business in Des Moines, Iowa, everybody there might be searching for office cleaners.
Right.
Whereas people in Chicago, they're searching for, facility cleaners or high-rise cleaners, something like that.
And people in California are searching for, how do I move out of California? I couldn't help myself. I had to throw. Oh, I should have said Canada. I'm always busting Canada's chops. All right, never mind. Go ahead, buddy.
But then once you understand that, then that's when you really hone in and you can start tailoring your ad experience to that person. So the people searching for commercial cleaning see the specific ads of commercial cleaners in X area, in Fargo, North Dakota, in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, offering X, Y, and Z pain point. This is the offer. You know, this is why we're the best. And because you've already kind of seasoned the ad account, you've seasoned your keywords, you know what people are searching for, you're going to now start to show at the top, because that's a tailored ad experience for that person. And it's going to beat out all the generalistic, Jan Pros, franchisees that are all out there. And you will end up at the top. So people search for commercial cleaning. They're going to see that and they go, oh, they click on this, or, oh, I'm going to give you a call. And that's when it really starts to ramp up, because that's when while you still are only spending like $11-$15 a day at max, you're getting leads in there based off of that really cheap spend. And those bids and leads are adding up and convert, way down the line.
All right. So as we wrap it up, what's the number one? And again, the reason I love having Jackson on is day in, day out, it's not like we talk about doing this. This is what he does every day with all of our Next Level Millionaire Mastermind people. He's in their accounts with them daily. So really finding out what works and what doesn't work. So for those guys and gals that are wanting to kind of dip their foot in, their toe in the Google waters, but they're a little scared, they don't have a Jackson, what would be your biggest kind of thing to do? And the number one kind of warning you to be like, watch out and don't do this.
Yeah. So biggest thing to do, honestly, go to ads.google.com, start an account, and do a walkthrough to do what Google calls a smart campaign, and try to push calls to your business and run it at like $5 a day for your local area. That's the best thing you can do right off the bat.
And that's $150 a month. So pretty hard. Even if it goes terribly, you're not going to be broke.
At max, Mike, because Google doesn't spend the max daily. So it might spend $1 one day. It might spend $6 another day. But at the most, the most you'll spend is $150. But that's where I start people if they've never started ads. That's our starting point. So if you can get started on that now, the data you'll have will be invaluable down the line once you start ramping this up or turning it up and getting more confident in it. That's my biggest thing to get started with, because the risk is quite minimal. The risk is really $150. And the reward is potentially a lot more.
Love it. And what's the opposite? What's the one thing that people are doing that you would tell them to stop doing, the big kind of red flag they should look out for?
Honestly, the biggest red flag is like, don't be afraid to do it. And don't like, because you can't go wrong by starting it. And I don't get frustrated, but it's like people get worried or they think Google's too complex, and the platform is simplified. So don't be scared to go in and try it. Because you can always turn it off if you're really scared of, or don't want that to happen. So that's my biggest don't be afraid to do it, really.
Yeah, and if you have a $5 or $10 a budget day, and you let it run for a week or two, it's $100 or so, right? So the very minimum, cheap investment in your own marketing education, and the maximum, you get some leads. So, all right, guys, gals, if this has been helpful, but you're like, this all sounds good, and you say just go start, I'm still scared, man. If you would like our help with what that looks like and how to do it, you go to growmycleaningcompany.com. There's actually nothing for sale there, so you can't really sign up, so to speak, but there's all the content that we have. The best way to kind of know what the next steps are with us, I think we've got a chat on there that you can just chat with us, but also just there's probably the best training we've got, and the best next steps for us to help you is right in the on-demand training right there. It's all over the thing. It's free masterclass. growmycleaningcompany.com. Check it out. We've got tons of stuff to help you grow, and hopefully soon Jackson will be able to help you one-on-one help your stuff. Talk to you soon, Clean Nation. Thanks for tuning in to today's show. If you're fired up, ready to grow, and want to see if you have what it takes to work with us at Grow My Cleaning Company, here's what I want you to do right now. Go to growmycleaningcompany.com/talk. That's growmycleaningcompany.com/talk to book an appointment to speak with me personally. I'm going to jump on the phone with you to get you crystal clear on where you are now, where you want to be, and how to get you there. Don't walk around in the dark any longer. If you are serious about growing your cleaning company, it's time to finally get the systems in place that you need to grow. We've helped hundreds of owners of cleaning companies not only grow their business and their personal freedom, but give back to their community as well. If that's what you're looking for, head over to growmycleaningcompany.com/talk and book a time to talk with me personally. I can't wait to get to know you and your business.